warm, high in the mid-80s.
Indiana's economy is improving, but it's about 2 months behind the nation as a whole, according to IU economist Morton Marcus. Marcus says our economy will pick up as the demand for cars and home appliances increases, because he says our state is still heavily reliant on its industrial base.
Manufacturing is the dominant force in the state in the sense that it contributes somewhere between 37 and 40% of the earned income of the people of Indiana, and it has a great deal of volatility to it. It moves around a great deal, and in this recession, of course, it's been one of the contributing factors to Indiana's lagging performance, but it will also be a major contributor to our recovery.
Marcus says most signs indicate better times are ahead. He says Indiana's unemployment rate will show gradual improvement and predicts the economy will continue to gain momentum through next year. Ken Owen, WIBC News.
On the national economic front, retail sales were up just above 2% last month. Wholesale prices.
Some of the city's dirtier characters are due to get cleaned up. Ken Owen has the dirt on this unusual undertaking.
The Benjamin Harrison statue in University Park was dedicated 75 years ago. And John Duggar of the Historic Landmarks Foundation says it's apparently never been cleaned. By the middle of this week, Duggar hopes to begin bringing the bronze statue back to its original state. He says the wear and tear of 75 years has damaged the likeness of Harrison, but is confident the restoration will be successful.
Our intent is to simply remove that surface layer without damaging the metal, the bronze underneath, or the patina, which gives the bronze its characteristic color.
Duggar says the cleanup won't take long. It should be completed sometime next week. He's hoping once work on the Harrison statue is completed, other bronze statues in the downtown area can be cleaned up as well. Duggar says the monuments have historic links to the past, but they're eyesores in their present condition. Ken Owen, WIBC News.
Uncle Sam may fine some Hoosier mobile home park operators up to $5,000 a day for failing to submit required...
Are available to Indianapolis teenagers. A report on that. Good evening. This is WIBC News.
An additional 200 Indianapolis youngsters will have a job this summer, thanks to an appropriation from the federal government. Mayoral aide Tom Henry explains.
The Department of Labor has provided us with an additional $230,000 for summer youth employment this summer, and that's going to allow the Division of Employment and Training to place another 200 kids in summer jobs between now and the beginning of the school year, and that will bring the total number of kids involved in the summer youth program up to about 1,800.
Henry says the positions will be filled by youngsters who have already applied through the Indianapolis public school system. He says it's doubtful any more kids will be hired through the program this summer because funds are dried up and the beginning of school is just a few months away. Ken Owen, WIBC News.
From Washington tonight, a defeat for President Reagan. Congress voted to limit this year's income tax. Stuff lately about our nation's schools. How are the kids really learning? Ken Owen filed this optimistic report.
Indianapolis public school students in kindergarten through the 12th grade took the Iowa Basic Skills Test this spring. The results of that test are now in, and they show improvement over last year's figures. Superintendent James Adams says of the 120 areas tested, IPS students scored at or above the national level in 68 categories, or nearly 57% of them.
I'm very happy to say that significant gains have been made this year in our system, particularly in our elementary schools, and that's where you really make long-term gains in your secondary schools, is if you have a sound foundational program in the elementary schools.
Adams says the high elementary school scores indicate the school system has been doing a good job for the past few years. But high school students scored lower. Adams says the older pupils have suffered from the instability that has plagued IPS over the past decade. Adams is happy that overall scores are up, but says there's room for even more improvement. Ken Owen, WIBC News.
Open the front door to your house, and what do you see?
Ken Owen has a story.
When it's as hot as it's been over the past few days, it's best to limit the amount of time you spend outdoors. That from Dr. Alan Fisher of the IU School of Medicine. Dr. Fisher says when temperatures are in the 90s, the risk of suffering heat exhaustion is high.
The best thing to do to avoid it, of course, is to stay in where it's nice and cool and air-conditioned. But if you have to be out, of course, wear loose-fitting white clothing. Try not to exercise too much. It'll run up the body temperature and, you know, delay jogging or tennis until the sun goes down or something of that nature. Main thing is to just avoid doing things that will cause the body heat to go up more.
Dr. Fisher says by staying in the sun too long, you also risk suffering heat stroke, which can put your body in a...